Thank you for playing.
Brian, we need you to explain the premise.
Ready, we start. Let's go.
My family lived on the southern edge of a certain Midwestern industrial city in an old house old enough that its basement is had a dirt floor.
I was not yet old enough to openly question a parent's behavior, but certainly old enough to recognize its oddness when my father began digging.
I retain only a single clear memory of the time before the situation became slamming?
Alarming.
And my father
soaked
sunlight forever.
I am sitting at the bottom of the wooden stairs that led down to our basement. Ahead in the dimness stands my father, up to his waist in the hole.
The fuck?
Still in his dark blue uniform from the factory, skin and fabric blackened by the hot breath of machinery and further smudged now by the damp earth, I watch father with the satisfaction of a child who sees in her parent a well of limitless capability.
Upstairs, my mother called out that dinner is done. My father takes one last shovel of earth, turns it over the side of excavation, and in a single incredible motion, crawls out of the hole simply by pressing the sole of his boots to the lip of the pit and moving his whole body upward, walking right past me, right up the stairs.
He was always a tall, angular man, as the remaining picture of him suggested, and to this day I can clearly conjure the marvelous image of my father's long, long legs striding over me as he emerged from the hole he was to spend years digging beneath our house.
Apart from him, there were three of us. My mother, my younger brother, and myself.
Alex, you gotta choose.
Myself! A year or so before we left, my father was the last time I ventured down into the basement. Did I read that right?
Yeah.
Oh,
fuck. My brother was out with friends, having reached the age when the family realized the awkwardness that resulted from bringing visitors to our home, and mother had locked the door to her room and apparently gone to bed. Father was, of course, laboring in the basement, and I was doing homework in the living room while watching television. There came a knock at the door.
Oh.
Okay. The man on the porch was squat, but dressed neatly in a suit, coat, and hat. A pair of very small spectacles was perched on the end of his nose, looking minuscule in comparison to his large, round face. "Hello, young lady," he said to me in a labored voice. "Is your father home?"
"Who are you?" I asked. The man tipped his old-fashioned hat back on his head, smiling with rubbery lips. "You have no reason to know of me, of course," he said, "but I am your uncle."
Cute. I left the man on the porch, the door locked, while I went to seek my mother's help. Thus I discovered she was unresponsive, as she often was in those days. This left me with the only option to summon my father from the basement.
He did not respond when I opened the door and yelled down, though I thought I could hear faintly the sound of his digging. I looked back to the front door where I could see through the pebbled glass the rotund figure of the man who claimed to be my uncle and descended the wooden stairs into the basement.
The only light, as always, came from a single bulb hanging from the ceiling. My father had learned to operate in these conditions, but for me, the lack of illumination cast the labyrinth below into a mess of confusing and seemingly contradictory paths of damp black earth and the only slightly blacker shadow.
Father had first attempted to dig straight down, but as years went on, he elaborated his original plans, angling outward from the center of the basement at a depth perhaps 15 feet, I can't see. from there, he had begun to hollow out the entirety of the basement with one long looping path threaded and bent around itself like some monstrous length of
viscera.
All while continuing his march downward.
I stood on the bottommost stair. Stare that, as I thought of it, still... Why is this happening? still properly belonged to our house. By my feet was a stack of unfamiliar books. They were old, with blank but warped brown covers. Next to them was that appeared to be an antique child's rattle, caked with dirt, and several rocks chipped into various unnatural but vaguely instrumental shapes. I turned to the void and called for my father.
No response came, but I grew more restless than I could hear. However, distantly, the sound of Father's shovel, I called for his, for him again, this time giving also my purpose for interrupting his work. There's a man at the door, I said. He says he's my uncle. I stood and waited, and as I did so, the sound of digging stopped.
My father emerged a minute or so later, unfolding himself from the narrow bend of his maze, his pale skin covered only by the rags of his clothing and everywhere dusted gray with soil, including, I noted, the corners of his mouth, which seemed strained particularly thoroughly, and much more darkly. Your uncle, Father rumbled, as quite asking a question. He then added, my brother. I nodded. Show him in, he ordered.
The squat stranger, my uncle, whom I remembered, smelled of sour milk, seemed slated at his prospects. I led him down the basement stairs, his agitation growing exponentially until he saw my father standing at his full height. It must have been at least 8 or 9 feet then, I think, at the entrance of his renovations. I knew to take my leave, and as I ascended the stairs, I heard the visitor remark that my father seemed to have done very well for himself, all things considered.
I never again saw the man who claimed to be my uncle, either that day or any day after. Perhaps not coincidentally, this is also my last clear memory of my father, and the one that returned to me many years later when my brother suggested we return to our father's house.
Brother and mother had their own experiences in the house, one which I can only relate only partially. Laura Pick.
Mother. There are many things about my mother I do not understand. She first found my father attractive. She admitted to me many years later because of how unusual he was.
Oh, sorry. I was like, oh, what happens next? He had come to the Midwestern industrial town and secured a job at the same factory where my mother was working. Though a practical man, he had constantly and voraciously in his subjects ranging from engine repair to philosophy, a habit instilled in him, he claimed, by his own parents.
This is all my father ever said of his family beyond us. Any further inquiry into the subject caused him to leave the room or bring up some other pressing issue. Mother once theorized that father had run away from home.
Sorry. Whatever his reasons for leaving his family behind, my father did not wait long before beginning a new one. I was only born a few months after my parents were married.
Within a few years, father made enough money that my mother could stay home and watch over me, and not long after, my brother. Then one night, when my brother was perhaps only a year old, father came home, pulled a brand new shovel from the back of his pickup truck, and descended into the basement, where he began to dig.
At first, he told mother he was preparing to put down a cement floor, suggesting a prelude to a full or partial renovation of the house. As a child, the movements of adults were still largely mysterious to me, and I did not know the specific circumstances under which mothers realized his motive was untrue.
Nor do I know exactly what transpired when father told mother that they must go to the basement to discuss the matter closer to its source. For after the door shut behind them, my brother and I were left alone in the house.
My brother cried most of the night while I lay in my own bed, pillows pressed to my ears. The next day, my mother reappeared, quietly preparing our meal, and then locked herself in her bedroom shortly before Father returned home and commenced digging once again.
My father, for his part, stopped sleeping in the bedroom with her, instead taking to the basement, a decision which coincided with the first signs of a terrible metamorphosis.
The changes were slow but noticeable. Father began to grow paler, and by the time the factory closed, he could spend the whole day in the basement. He was as white as chalk. Perhaps it was this general evidence of where the change in skin and his subsequent emaciation that made him look taller, as if his height increased in proportion to the depth of his project in the basement. Meanwhile, my mother put my brother into preschool and sent me to a latchkey program while she worked to support us. In what seemed a deliberate contrast to my father, she grew somehow darker and smaller.
Can't read. Can't see. Yeah, my father dug uninterrupted in the basement for at least a decade, and once I started high school, he did not even leave the basement to join us for dinner when my mother left him. Or then my mother left him.
Father was sufficiently enveloped in his life's task that there was no need to replay the arguments from my childhood. Whatever desire he once had to keep us home with him had apparently fallen away, lost in the depths of the pit.
On our own, Mother seemed to physically decompress, to become less bowed?
I think so, yeah.
She spoke more, laughed more, she had friends and lovers. We did not see my father at all after we left.
On the day we left for good, he did not even come out of the basement, though by that point it was questionable how easily he could get through the doorway, so tall he had grown. It was not until many years later that my brother suggested we pay a return visit to our father's house.
My brother had always been a bit more sentimental regarding the matter.
My brother was young enough when my father began digging that it seemed to him an indifferent fact of life.
Oh. Fuck. It seemed obvious to me that something was wrong with our home. It's what?
It's
wrongness. Its wrongness was screamed, I thought, by the chilly.
Oh gosh.
Terseness. I can't read any of this. With which our mother moved through it, returning home from work in the first late afternoon, serving meals and retiring to her bedroom. The wrongness was screamed, of course, by my father, who, after losing his job in the factory, spent nearly all day in the basement, emerging at irregular intervals to eat and use the toilet. This is to say nothing of the physical changes he underwent as time went on.
The wrongness was screened by my own actions, the heavy worry I felt that any moment the fragile equilibrium of our home would be upset, and my brother's friends would witness the terrifying truth of my family situation. A situation I myself could not begin to articulate, but which I felt ashamedly that an outsider would. Of course, my brother, young as he was, saw nothing wrong with inviting his friends to our home, and even taking them down to the basement to see what he called, after our father's example, I believe, the renovations.
The friends never asked to return to the basement after my brother took them down there. What'd you say?
I never asked for this.
Some of them quietly deigned to never return to our house at all, much to my relief, though my brother was often disappointed. I recall only one instance when my brother was perhaps 7, when one of his playmates made a scene.
I believe my brother's friends came from a religious family, which may have been a part of the problem, but that may also be something I can't recognize only due to my own biases. At any rate, though his cosmology was different from my own, he at least shared some of the anxieties when he attempted to explain to my brother that our father's project in the basement was deeply unnatural.
I emerged from the living room because down the hall I could hear crying. I knew that my brother had a friend over and so was prepared for the worst. The two boys stood outside the door to the basement, which still stood open. My brother looked up as I approached, at a loss as to how to comfort his weeping companion.
"You are going to hell," our visitor informed me after I managed to get him to look at me. "That's where he's digging to down there," the child said, looking from me to my brother. "He's digging to hell, and you're all going with him."
Jesus Christ. My brother did not invite any classmates over after that day, and I don't believe he ever invited any of them down to see the renovations ever again. Oh, shit.
"Are you really going to hell?" he asked me one night, lying beside me in bed after nightmares sent him to my room. I told him I did not know. "But, shit, is that where Dad is digging to?" he asked. I told him there was no such place. "Then why is Dad digging?"
Oh, okay. "In the early days, when I sat on the stairs and watched him work, my father had given me dozens of flippant reasons for his project, seeking dinosaur bones. All of these excuses had lost currency by this point, of course. And when asked what he was doing, as my brother told me, his religious visitor had inquired, my father had other things to say."
It's getting darker.
Yeah, I was going to say, I like...
Oh, shit, what the fuck?
Oh, no!
Read the top one. Daphne, read the top one.
"This is not the real world," my father would say, or something along those lines.
"What we think is the real world is just a layer of dirt caked around the true core of the universe."
"And what is dirt? Insert matter.
Inert
matter. Dead weight. The remains of those who came and went before us, content only to further press down upon the creation with their waste."
"There was a time when human beings were giants walking upon a small earth, but now the earth had grown fat and hateful with ourselves, while we have grown small." Oh, soil. My bad.
Soiled it. "Starting here, I am scraping away this sediment, our coagulated filth, and returning us to our original glory." Okay. Oh my god, fucking.
"I assembled this manifesto from memory from various iterations and variations Father offered us over the years, and certainly it was our sort of heresy that had offended my brother's erstwhile friend. Still, they were not satisfactory answers to us then, and would not be satisfactory for my brother as he huddled fearing hell in my bed. Oh, but frankly, I had no other answer for him and let the matter lapse into silence, which is perhaps why all these years later, he urged me to come with him back to our father's house."
Oh my god,
we're not gonna beat the pizza.
"It seemed my brother wanted to put his mind at ease by checking up on our father, who had been left alone now for slightly longer than we had lived with him. On one hand, I appreciated my brother's sentiment, even if I felt it was misplaced. On the other hand, I knew I could not stop him. His feelings toward father had always been more lenient. The only question was, would I go along with him or make him visit on his own? Choose."
Wait, what was it?
"You can choose to go along with him or visit on his own."
Let's go along with him.
Bye, Daphne.
Oh man, it's black.
Wait, am I reading or is she reading?
Oh, wait, no. You're reading.
Okay. "We decided upon a day to visit our childhood home, where we assumed our father still lived, and decided to meet there one afternoon the following week. But there must have
somewhere
been a miscommunication."
Okay. Oh, no. "I was late. I must have been late. And the alternative is that, for his own purposes, my brother arrived early to see our father before I did. I do not wish to contemplate why this would be. Or why that would be.
The town is considerably less industrial than it had been, though the taste of industry still laced our water and air. The old neighborhood, not the most affluent even in former times, had fallen into further disrepair. The houses up and down the block stood weathered and it seemed empty. The sidewalks buckled around thick protrusions of sickly weeds, which reached out into the potholed street, protruding fingers of the overgrown lawns. The only sign of habitation was a single car, my brother's car, parked outside of our old home.
The doors were locked, the windows rolled up, a hand pressed to the hood told me that it was not warm, but apart from that, I had no way of guessing how long the vehicle had been unattended. Ahead, the house waited.
It seemed not much different from the rest of the buildings, scrapped down to the gray bones by the elements. The windows were gone, without even slivers of glass remaining, and the porch had bowed and now held a stagnant pool of rainwater. The front door stood open at an angle, its lowermost hinge having rusted and snapped in two.
God! Stop being carefully on the rotten porch. I slipped inside and found myself in the old living room. The floor was littered with trash and chunks of paper dropped from the ceiling. The television was gone, though a lighter patch in the shredded wallpaper marked its former location. The couch had collapsed and now seemed covered with mounds of some sort of gray mold or fungus. Ahead was the central hallway of the house, and I could see that the door to the basement had been wholly removed.
I called out my brother's name and then stood for a moment, looking down into the unremitting darkness. Of course the power was out. It was probably disconnected long ago, but a flashlight lay on the floor just outside the basement entrance.
My brother, huh? My brother's? I thought it was his name. The flashlight seemed quite... Not old. Quite new. I flicked it on and pointed it down the basement, but it penetrated far enough, only to reveal the foot of the stairs. I called my brother's name again and waited. There was still no response.
Oh, shit, man.
Assuming the basement was anything like as I had last seen it, my brother could have easily gotten hurt if he went down without his flashlight. He might have been lying down there just beyond the stairs, unconscious. I had to make sure.
Flashlight ready, I went into the basement.
Fucking...
Oh shit!
Oh shit!
Oh god! Oh, that's in the way!
Oh my god!
Oh god!
Oh my emotions!
Okay, Alex, you'll read the top two lines. I'll read the next two lines.
All right. The stairs creak beneath my feet. Okay, there's nothing there. I reach the bottom.
Fucking. And when my flashlight returned, only a slope heading deeper beneath the house. I know my father had done quite a bit of work in the decades since we left. Okay, so there's nothing left.
No, you have to click
quite
a bit of work, yeah.
Fuck.
Okay. I went down.
Oh, fuck.
That's a lot of things to pick.
I called for my brother. I walked to the left. I walked to the right.
Shit.
Call for your brother. I think. Only my own breathing echoed back through those chambers of barren earth. I walked further into the darkness.
Alex.
Fucking...
Barren earth. Shovel Knight.
Around me, there was nothing but darkness.
Oh, fucking shit, man.
I walked further onward. I called for my brother again and received no answer. The path branched left and right.
Come on.
Okay.
Shit.
Laura, did you call for your brother?
No.
Did you go left or right?
Wait, is the top answer? One?
Oh, did you go onward. Further onward? Did you call for your brother and receive no answer, or did you go left or right?
Let's go left.
Always go left.
I follow the sound of dick. Oh, wait, no, it's Daffy.
I follow the sound of digging the path my father had eaten through the earth, stretched out in all directions. There was no sign of my brother.
Eaten. Oof. Oh shit, man. I took a deep breath. I followed the sound of digging. I followed the closest. Ryan, I need you to move the flashlight.
Sorry.
I followed the closest turn in the path.
Oh, fucking oh, shit.
Breathe!
Breathe!
Deep breath.
Around there was nothing but darkness. I followed the sound of digging.
Fuck, man!
Digging. Oh, you gotta go there. As I was going in circles, how could I even be able to tell? I follow the sound of digging. I took a downward sloping path to the left. I called my brother's name.
Go left! Left! Always go left! Left!
Always
left.
Go left!
I can't roll.
Oh my god.
Oh, it's the same thing.
I followed the sound of digging. Oh,
oh fuck, man.
Stretched out path. Ooh. Oh my god.
Alright, so I'm gonna start doing this.
Yeah.
Just going through digging. I call her brother again. I turn right.
Musty smell.
The musty smell of old.
Do that one.
Around there was nothing but darkness. Okay, we're gonna follow the digging.
Again?
I was going in circles. I don't even be able to tell. I followed the sound of digging. I looked downward on a sloping path to the left. I called my brother's name.
In the direction, wait.
In the distance, the sound of shoveling did not break its rhythm, as if the digger did not know who I was there or was there. Following the sound of digging, I followed it further into the darkness.
The digger.
Where was my brother? I followed the sound of digging. I once left.
Where?
That's the newest one, I guess.
Oh, let's pick
it's the newest one, yeah.
This is
Damn it.
Oh, okay. Break rhythm, digging.
Into the darkness. Okay. Star Trek into the darkness.
Shit. Fuck. Shit! Fuck! Shit!
My search, but once I saw what lived there, what had been fuck? Living there all those years, or more precisely what had gone down there, I ran from the beast.
What the fuck?
Somehow, by my own luck or by some other's design, I made it out of that darkness, though my brother was not. There is a chance, I think, that he may still be alive.
No, fuck that shit, get out of there.
Fuck.
My guilt is quite heavy, but do not doubt that, but it is outweighed by the fear I experienced when I came face to face with that terrible result of my father's attempted renovations of our rotted world.
Oh, shit.
I once told my brother there is no such place as hell.
Oh, fuck, man.
What the shit?
Oh god, it's the long legs!
What is it?
I wonder if he's grown as tall as our home father.
What the shit?
That wasn't there before! Father's long legs!
Oh fuck.
Oh shit!
Oh, it's done! We beat the pizza!
Yeah!
Wait, we did?
Twin,
yeah! That's the end of the game!
That's it?
Yeah!
Liar, is it really?
Oh, yeah. It's like.
What the shit, man?
What the fuck is that?
Oh, that was really good.
That was super
fucking hell!
That was built-in immersion.
Fuck!
We beat the pizza.
We didn't explain what this was at all.
Oh, yeah, this is a game in which we try to beat the game before the pizza gets here.
Oh, my God.
What?
Sorry.
Oh, my God.
I'm sorry.
I mean, actually, though? Well, there.
I don't want pizza no more.
So, this whole time I was trying to think, of course.
Mm-hmm.
It was some sort of psychological disorder.
Oh.
It's not. I don't know what the fuck that was.
That was something else.
Apparently this has multiple endings.
Does it?
Oh.
No.
That sounds interesting.
Okay, read the pizza. Bye.
Bonus toppings.
Bonus
Let's
toppings.
Go.